Hello, I'm Kirsten Anderson. I am with the town of Dillon, and I'm here with Mayor Kevin Burns.
Hello.
Welcome to the Dillon Council update.
So we're here to discuss our work session and town council meeting from this last Tuesday, which I believe was September 1st, correct?
Yeah, September 1st. And what did happen, Kevin?
So we'll start off with the work session. First thing, we got an update from Josh Blanchard with Lake Dillon Theater Company, just kind of giving us his usual quarterly update, running through some of the programs. Sounds like they've been having a great summer.
Yeah.
Sold out shows, some of their longest runs on shows. I was particularly glad to hear that that they've been having successful concert series.
Yep.
One of the things that a lot of people probably know about our amphitheater is that when you have a lot of rain, less people show up. That's one of the things we've kind of been looking at, is how to make it a little bit more of a rain or shine facility.
That's right.
But it's been gorgeous Saturday nights all summer, and I think they said they've only had kind of one rain out. So we're happy to hear that they've had sort of successful fundraising and shows all summer long.
Yep, beautiful Saturdays. Tom Breslin also gave us his manager update.
Mm-hmm.
He talked about the Ensign project.
Yep, that's right. Yeah, so as a lot of folks know who've been watching us sort of year in and year out, we've been working on a street reconstruction program for many years now, since before I was on council. And we completed one of the last major chunks, the Ensign Drive reconstruction, and that is a area with a bunch of houses. It's fairly impactful for the local community. But our crews are out there working on it. Had great communication with the local residents, and we actually got words of thanks coming back our way. Some great congratulations for Dan Burrows and Ed West on that, and their whole team. It's not always the case you do a major construction project like that and people come away happy and grateful with the way you did the work, but we were able to get done a reconstruction on a pretty deteriorated road. Came in ahead of schedule and under budget, which is always the way you want these things to go. So we're very happy with the work, and it sounds like the residents in that area are pretty pleased with the new product. So.
Yep. It's nice to see Ned back in the office again.
Yep.
And speaking of budgets, Carrie McDonald kicked off the 2016 budget process with us on the 1st.
Yeah, so again, everybody, the folks who follow every episode, every season, know that we start our budget process right around now, and it pretty much goes every meeting through the end of the year. So we were all very excited to get to dive back into the budget this last meeting. And what we really did was we looked at the capital and street improvement funds that this time around. Healthy budgets. Luckily, it's been a good year. It seems like we're kind of coming out of the recession that we were certainly in the middle of when I first got on council, and it's nice to be able to start this budget with a lot of funds in the green versus
yeah.
the other direction. So we do have $2.8 million in capital projects, including improvements for the amphitheater, overlays for Little Beaver Trail and Labonte Street, and reconstruction of Lodgepole Street from the marina parking lot to the intersection of Lake Dillon Drive. So that's, again, continuing a lot of that street reconstruction we've been doing. We're starting to really put money into those amphitheater improvements that I mentioned a little bit earlier here.
Uh-huh. Yep. So speaking of that, there was a resolution to sign that contract to move forward with mm-hmm. the Marina Master Plan.
Yep.
And that work is really going to be focused on bathroom improvements, mm-hmm. Expanding concession, and mm-hmm. Working on the loading area down
yeah.
there.
Yeah, so what's interesting about this, just to give people a little bit of context, I know we've talked about this on the program a little bit before, but for folks who don't remember, we essentially took an old, there was an old plan to do some of this amphitheater work. Again, before the recession hit, we ended up with a lot less funds. That's the sort of program that you kind of put on hold while you don't have the resources available, and you do have to work on maintaining your streets and doing
yes.
all that stuff. But since we do have a little bit more flexibility now, it seemed like it made a lot of sense. The lakefront really is the jewel of Dillon. Working on the marina, the park, and then the amphitheater down there is really where we want to kind of be spending some of this money that we have available. And so we're really excited to be able to sort of continue working on a project that started really years ago, and we're able to kind of do this major step forward, and that's going to be I think a pretty exciting process. We're you see it every weekend. There's people spilling out onto the streets, long lines to the bathroom. You see lines wrapping around at the concession stands, going around the block. Essentially, it's it'll be really nice to have some of those amenities.
Those delicious hot dogs from
I had one last Saturday. They cooked those hot dogs to perfection. I can see why they're in demand. But it'll be great to be able to meet the needs of the visitors that we have in town. That if you're a local resident, you don't necessarily want to see people spilling out into the streets as you're trying to get home. If you're a guest coming up for the weekend, you don't necessarily want to wait 45 minutes in line for a hot dog or a beer. You want to be able to just come in and enjoy the amphitheater.
The music that's been great all year.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, the other thing we talked about was a resolution to authorize Silverthorn to act as the managing mm-hmm. agency for the Dillon Silverthorn Joint Sewer Authority. Mm-hmm. So they were looking to appoint a new operations superintendent. Mm-hmm. Talk to us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so one of the things that, one of the things that I hear a lot is, what kind of collaborative work can you do with the towns around you? And we actually, we do a lot with the town of Silverthorn. The Joint Sewer and Water Authority makes a lot of sense. It's been a great cost savings for both towns. Silverthorn is the, what do they call it, the registered agent on the authority. So they actually, so they're really the ones who manage it. So what they were looking for us is, they made an internal hire. They wanted to make sure that we were okay with it. Mm-hmm. And of course, they do a lot of great work there. Have great staff who are involved, and we were completely fine with their selection. I'm actually trying to find the
Simon Stokes.
Yeah,
actually,
Simon Stokes.
Yes.
So apologize, Simon. Hope you're watching. we've heard good things, and our staff has great respect for Simon. So there was no concerns there, and we were happy to see that process continue and to support it. So
great. All right, that moves us into the next resolution we talked about. Obviously, we've been talking mm-hmm. as a community about the revitalization of mm-hmm. The town core for some many, many years now. Mm-hmm. Yep. And the conversation that took place on Tuesday was the next step in that process. Mm-hmm. And we were taking a look at replatting some of the property within town. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I won't dive into the weeds too much since we've discussed this on many, many versions uh-huh. of this program and the Dillon Dialogue and everything.
Yeah.
But this was replat. We were looking at replatting some additional town land. We had a great community turnout. Uh-huh. Took a lot of public comment based on that, and a lot of the interests of residents, business owners, property owners. We decided to table the replatting for now. We were asked to keep working with some of the community, keep yep. reaching out. A lot of folks a lot of stakeholders who want to be involved but want to see, want to be able to kind of talk through this process a little bit more, which I'm completely happy with.
Yeah.
I think that's a great, sort of a great example of how this process works. And I know that council's excited to sort of keep working on moving this forward with folks. So.
Yeah, and I know personally that's a role that I get to step into, yeah. that community liaison, yeah. and I was so excited to see the turnout and mm-hmm. Listen to mm-hmm. What everyone had to say, and I look forward to yeah. continuing those conversations.
Yep, absolutely.
So a ordinance mm-hmm. was introduced, mm-hmm. 17-15. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so that's actually, that's really kind of, that's an ordinance that's really designed to sort of bring us into best practices around how we use some of our land. There's a lot of, as well there should be, there's a lot of sort of rules governing wetlands protection here locally, around the state, federally. Mm-hmm. And we were basically just readjusting our setbacks on how far up you can develop to a wetlands. Mm-hmm. We're decreasing that a little bit to allow some more land for development. But one of the things I've been asked personally, and we've kind of been asked is, what does this mean for environmental protection? One of the things I'm happy to say is that this doesn't mean you start building on wetlands or any environmentally sensitive areas. You still have these requirements in place to make sure that that the environment's protected. This just allows some land that the standards of the day say, this isn't, you don't necessarily have to keep this untouched in order to protect these areas. It uh-huh. lets us be able to find other uses for it, whether that be park, residential, business, and it just gives the town a little bit more flexibility, and developers a little more flexibility when they're planning. So,
great. Wrapping up sort of the community news, we're having a community chat that's coming up. That's going to be September 9th at 5:30 p.m. Can you talk a little bit about the intent of those community chats?
Yeah, so we do community chats, I believe it's quarterly ideally, and although occasionally scheduling messes around with that a little bit, but it's really just an opportunity for folks to be able to come in and chat with their town council folks. In a normal meeting, there's pretty rigid rules of conduct around like what you can, the kind of back and forth you can and can't have with the public. Anytime if there's a, you know, if there's a item of great interest to folks, if they come, they'll, you know, they'll give public comment, but we're really not allowed to respond.
As I'm learning.
Or it's frowned upon anyways. And you don't want to get in a back and forth situation in that, but we wanted to create an environment where you could have a more casual conversation, get what's, you know, talk a little bit more about what's on the minds of folks in the community, where, you know, what's the perspective of the town council person, and there's no, by intent, there's no set agenda. We want to, you know, we want to be able to hear what questions folks have on any array of issue, anything they want to bring up. We get a pretty good mix of folks who come into these things with, you know, all sorts of stuff, whether it's the hot topic of the day. Some people have concerns about what's happening right in their front yard. Uh-huh. If it's a, you know, we field all sorts of stuff. I remember one of the first ones we did was about, people were wondering how we polish some of our Dillon signs, which I had no idea and had to look into, but there's a maintenance regimen for all that, of course, and was able to kind of gather up that information. But so it can be on any number of issues, so we're always happy to kind of host these events here in town.
Awesome, so we hope to see everyone there September 9th at 5:30 in Town Hall. Mm-hmm. Kevin, did you get a chance to see the Best of Summit recently?
I did. That was exciting. That came out Monday, I believe, correct?
Yeah,
so Dillon essentially...
killed it.
Dillon killed it. We had a bunch of finalists and first place finishes around the town.
Hold the list because we had the best biking trail along the rec path here. Mm-hmm. We had the best park at the Marina Park, which is so nice to see the work pay off there. Mm-hmm. Although that's long been a favorite. Mm-hmm. We had the best apres at the Dam Brewery, best entertainment venue, so hooray for amphitheater, best barbershop with the Gentleman's Barbershop here, best chiropractor, best optometrist, best bike shop with Wilderness Sports, best liquor store with the Dillon Ridge Liquors, best retail boutique with Alp and Glow, best mountain outfitter, Wilderness Sports again, best Asian and best sushi bar with Nozawa, best bartender with our very own Jason Hodges, way to go, Jason, best bar with the Dam Brewery, best barbecue at the A Cafe, best brew pub at the Dam again, best deck at Pug Ryan's. So really well represented at our small little town.
Yep, absolutely. So if anybody wants to come out and check out any of the best of all the various categories, just come on down to Dillon.
Yep. Okay, a few more reasons to come down to Dillon. While summer is wrapping up and we are heading into the Labor Day weekend here, we still have a few more farmers markets. So they'll be down here through the 18th of September. Lots of vendors still here, lots of great food. I'm smelling it right now and I'm starving, so I can't wait to go grab some lunch. But we obviously have our final concert. So Friday is the final DBA concert. That's gonna be Miss the Boat. It's a bluegrass band. They're from Steamboat Springs. They've come a couple of years, really a locals favorite. Mm-hmm. Saturday is the last Sunset Series concert, and that is the Big Kahuna Beach Party. Mm-hmm. And they're obviously
a Beach Boys cover band.
Exactly, so very popular. On Sunday, we're celebrating Labor Day with the Roger Walters 20th Congress. So awesome keyboardists down there. We're gonna have fireworks. Those will kick off at about 9 p.m. And then on Monday, we have our Marina Mutt contest.
That's always a winner. That's a local favorite. You see a lot of great dogs down there.
Right, a lot of best towel, best dog and owner look-alike contest. There's plenty to do even if you don't have a dog, so come on down. Yep. Registration for that is between 12 and 1:45, and then the event is from 2 to 4.
Yep.
And then finally, our last concert is gonna be Who's Bad. It's a Michael Jackson tribute band. Start practicing your moonwalk, Kevin. That's September 12th at 7 p.m. at the Dillon Amphitheater, and we hope to see everyone there.
Well, it'll be exciting. So I think that's probably everything from us, right?
That's it. Thanks for the update. Thanks for joining us today, and we'll see you next time on the Council Update.
All right. Thanks, everyone.